Hello, everybody. This is Outside the Press Box. I'm Sarah Jenkins, Jordan Henry, Stan Temming, Maria Papadakis. How are you guys doing today?
I just want to say hi to my mom. I'm on TV. Sorry for stealing your pantsuit this morning.
Hi, Jordan's mom. So we're going to talk about the show as we do every single week, and that is with the headlines. So it's been a horrendous season for Toronto's Jonathan Bernier. Coming off signing a two-year, $8.3 million contract, he has yet to win a game this season. An injury put backup James Reimer in net, and his amazing play have resulted in Mike Babcock giving him the soon-to-be UFA the number one spot for the time being. So this is what Mike Babcock had to say about that.
Has his personality sort of shone through? He's such an easygoing and lovable kind of guy.
Yeah, you know what, guys, I got nothing to go off because I don't know him from the past. I just know he's a good guy and he's battled hard. I mean, when he came out of training camp, he had had a good training camp, and the other guy got to play all the time. It would have been easy for him to, you know, feel bad for himself or be upset. He just dug in and played harder, or maybe he was upset. And he's just gotten better and better, and he gives us a chance each night he starts, so good for him.
So the numbers clearly favor Reimer heavily. His save percentage is third in the league, while his goals against average is seventh. So guys, let me know. Is Reimer the Leafs' number one goalie now?
Oh, by far. Like, Reimer's been playing so well. You mentioned his stats. He's been fantastic so far this season. But I want to point out, I think Bernier right now, definitely the better actor, right? His best Toskla impression on Broadway? Spot on.
I mean, guys, I'm checking my watch here, and I believe it is rhyme time, ladies and gentlemen. You've got to ride the hot hand. Get some oven mitts out, because this guy right now is hot. You got to go. You got a 1A and a 1B goaltender. They're in the upper echelon of goaltenders in the league. I mean, many would kill for a Bernier or Reimer in net, even though Bernier's not playing hot right now. You've got to go with the guy who's playing phenomenally at the time, and that man, James Reimer.
I totally agree with you, Jordan. Obviously, it's going to be a battle. Who's going to come on the ice what night, Bernier, Reimer? And they're always going to be a controversy who's playing better when. But right now, Reimer, you see it statistically, he is the number one.
So injuries got Bernier out. And speaking of injuries, Dallas Cowboys is dealing with a lot of them right now. So they were thought to be Super Bowl favorites this year, but injuries to Tony Romo and Dez Bryant has the team sitting at the bottom of the NFC East with a 3-8 record. The boys are two games behind the division-leading New York Giants. Their remaining schedule has them playing Washington twice, a trip to Lambeau, and the Jets and Bills after that. I mean, Tony Romo just got hurt again last night. Does this mean Dallas, their shot at playoffs, Super Bowl, totally out the window, or do they still have a shot?
Personally, I think they do not have a shot at all. You saw their game last night. They lost 33-14. You can't even do that, and the game was over before, you know, Romo was even hurt. They had a record of 2-7 when Romo was out. And honestly, if you can't play with your quarterback or without your quarterback, you're not making the playoffs.
I'm sorry, folks. Guys, I'm just getting breaking news from high school and NFL insider Nico Canavo that Tony Romo officially done for the rest of the year, guys. And I think that is going to be a serious hurt to the Dallas Cowboys. The only their wins are coming with Tony Romo in the lineup. The guys, up until last night, he was 3-0 going into it. Now 3-1 after last night's debacle. But going through with that, the Cowboys are done. I think it's toast. It's over. It's been a mess of a year for Jerry Jones and the boys.
It really is the New York Giants division to lose, in my opinion. I've heard that from a few good sources around. It's a crap division, but if you can get into the playoffs, who knows what happens after that.
Exactly.
Cowboys will not be there, though.
Exactly.
So no for the Cowboys. Other things to look forward to. The NHL has recently revamped its all-star game format. So that's coming up in the new year. And the viewership is decreasing year after year. So what are these changes exactly? Well, the fantasy draft, completely wiped clean. Like, not even a thing anymore.
So instead,
exactly. So instead, each of the four divisions will have a team representing them. Those teams will have 11 players, and the fans get to vote for the captain of each team. The best part about this is there's a $1 million prize up for the team that wins. Do you think these changes are going to make people want to watch the NHL All-Star game this year?
Definitely. I think incorporating the fans, being able to choose, you know, the captains and all that of the team, that's going to bring viewers regardless. Even if you're a regular hockey viewer or not, that's going to bring people to watch the All-Star game. I think it's going to be really cool.
How about instead of bringing people to watch, you literally bring fans into the game? That's right. Two NHL players, one fan on the ice at the same time. Would you like to see how hard somebody tries to win $1 million in a hockey game against NHL players? Going out there, throwing elbows on guys, battling hard all the way through. Bring the fans not just to the game, bring them into the game. That's an all-encompassing experience.
I like that idea.
Yeah, but then you think about insurance and stuff like that, and it could get a little dicey.
Just get a waiver, sign off on the waiver.
I would definitely drop the gloves, though.
Oh,
I would like. I've seen you. You're pretty feisty, Maria.
Maria and Dustin Byfuglien, a center ice tilt. Just one, two. Good night,
Almost
Byfuglien.
The same weight division.
100%.
So speaking of sending people out onto the ice, we actually sent M out to hang out with Ryerson Rams hockey player Brian Berghoff. He needed some help with his slap shot, so we sent M to be his goalie.
Start it. Zombie on the track. Started from the bottom, now we here. Started from the bottom, now my whole team here. Started from the bottom, now we here. Started from the bottom, now the whole team here. Started from the bottom, now we here. Started from the bottom, now my whole team here. Started from the bottom, now we here. Started from the bottom, now the whole team here. I done kept it real from the jump.
Hi guys, I'm here with Brian Berghoff of the Ryerson Rams men's hockey team, and he's gonna shoot some pucks on me today.
Working all night, traffic on the way home, and my uncle calling me like, where you at? I gave you the keys, so you bring it right back. I just think it's funny how it goes. Now I'm on the road, half a million for a show, and we started from the bottom, now we're here. Started from the bottom, now my whole team. Yeah, started from the bottom, now we're here. Started from the bottom, now the whole team here. Started from the bottom, now we here. Started from the bottom, now the whole team here. Started from the bottom, now we here. Started from the bottom, now the whole team here. Boys tell stories about the man. Say I never struggled, wasn't hungry, yeah, I doubt it. I could turn your boy into the man. There ain't really much out here that's popping up without us. We just want the credit where it's due. I'ma worry about me, give a about you, just as a reminder to myself.
So I think you just wanted to
honestly, I think you'd see me on the national team one day, let's be honest. Just saying. Now I feel like a boss. I saved like 8 out of 90.
So that was fantastic, and to check out actually more of us trying out things we're not good at, myself, Jordan and Maria went canoeing, and also we have the hashtag game all coming up after the commercial break here on Outside of the Press Box.
Well, you only need the light when it's burning low. Only miss the sun when it starts to snow. Only know you love her when you let her go. Only know you've been high when you're feeling low. Only hate the road when you're missing home. Only know you love her when you let her go. And you let her go.
We should outlaw the wave in baseball stadiums. No more of that, or you'll be arrested. Coaches in every single sport should have to wear the uniforms of that sport, not just baseball coaches. That's not fair. T-shirt guns should become burrito guns. When playing basketball, if you take 3 steps before dribbling, that should be a penalty. We should call that traveling.
Garbage Time with Katie Nolan, starting March 15th on Fox Sports 1.
Guys, and welcome back to Outside the Press Box. Now it's time for my favorite part of the show, and that's the hashtag game, where we take something happening in sports right now and our hosts come up with hashtags and I get to pick the winner. So let's get started. All right, so first hashtag, Dallas Cowboys quarterback Tony Romo was cleared to return from a broken collarbone last week. But last night, he re-injured his collarbone. Regardless, last week, he tweeted this video out.
Well, then I guess there's only one thing left to do.
What's that?
Win the whole f***ing thing.
All right, guys, so I need a hashtag for Tony Romo tweeting out that video. Maria.
All right, so I know Romo was trying to be all inspirational, but it's a no-go for Romo.
I like it. I like the rhyme. Go ahead, Zan. Your turn.
Okay, let's try something a little different. How about hashtag poor Tony, but no Romo?
Okay.
Okay. Right on. No, it's your turn.
We all know Tony Romo, married to Jessica Simpson. So
yeah, we do.
Hashtag Jessica Simps on and off the field, because he was on the field and then he broke his collarbone and now he's off the field.
I like that. Okay, so in my opinion, because I like the Jessica Simpson off, Jordan is our winner.
Funny play on words.
I like it.
I think mine is personally better, but it's okay.
Yeah, well everyone has that. Their own opinion, Maria. I'm the one that picks the winner. So next hashtag, the Maple Leafs have been playing well this season, and well, that's a first. In November, they have a record of 7-3-3. The team is flying high, and to such an extent that Mike Babcock, head coach, uttered the one word that fans never thought that they would ever hear this season, because they're in rebuilding for the next like 5 years, apparently. So let's hear what Babcock had to say. What was the word? But
we're 19 games in. I think we're 3 points out of a playoff spot, and so we got to keep building the group so that, you know, we'd like to be in the playoff spot.
All right, guys, so give me a hashtag for Babcock using the word playoff. Maria.
Sorry. Using the word playoff?
Using the word playoff?
We never had that one.
Yeah.
Give me a second then.
I don't got the word playoffs in mind, but.
You don't have to use the word playoffs in it. He's talking about playoffs, though. Stan, you can start.
Maria, I was really nervous there for half a second. Okay, got it. Everyone loves Billy Talent, great Canadian band. How about a hashtag Fallen Leafs? Fallen Leafs, Fallen Leafs on the ground?
What about,
I like it.
What about,
Jordan,
everybody knows the Jim Mora quote, playoffs? You know, Jim Mora, hashtag Jim Mora.
I like it. Maria, finish it off.
Hashtag Babcock dreams big, because I don't see that happening anytime soon.
All right, because I like leaves falling and I like fall, Stan, you win this one.
Thank you, Billy Talent.
You're welcome. All right, so last and final one, a topic that I and every girl in North America loves talking about, Justin Bieber. So recently, he was in an ET interview and apologized to UFC fighter Ronda Rousey for allegedly refusing to take a picture with her sister at a Cannes Film Festival. However, later in the interview, when asked if there's anything he'd like to improve on outside of music, this is what Bieber had to say. I would like to get better at boxing. Did you see Ronda Rousey? She got knocked out cold. Oh my God, she got knocked out so bad. Yeah, she got pummeled. So, what's the hashtag for Bieber calling out Rousey? Maria, let's start with you.
Hashtag Mayweather's be with an itch. That one's mine.
I like it. I like it. Stan, you got one ready?
Oh, just finish it off. It's a good one. So, like, you didn't take the photo with Ron Rousey's sister, right?
Yeah.
Hashtag sister probably isn't hot. Hashtag can't blame him.
You got the double hashtag on that
double
one.
Double hashtag, I like it. Jordan,
guys, there's a real advantage here to take advantage of Bieber's song titles. Hashtag beauty and a beatdown, because that's what's going to happen to the Biebs.
All right. As much as I love Stan and your hashtag, but Jordan, quoting one of my favorite Justin Bieber songs, you win this one. All right, so since childhood, we're told to expand our horizon and try new things, so three of our hosts did that. We went to the Mississauga Canoe Club. Let's see what happened when we went there. Or not. Oh. Hey guys, what's up? It's your host, Sarah, Maria, and Jordan, and we're here in Port Credit, Ontario at the Mississauga Canoe Club. We're gonna learn how to sprint, canoe, and kayak.
Should be interesting, that's for sure.
Have you guys ever canoed or kayaked before?
Hundreds of times.
I went once in Cuba.
A little colder here than in Cuba. This is actually the last day the club was on the water because the water is getting too cold. So we'll see how this goes, but we should probably get some help from some athletes. So let's get some people from the canoe club to actually show us what we're doing.
Be interesting, that's for sure. I've only ever gone kayaking once in Cuba, and we didn't even last long. I couldn't even get myself in the boat or kayak, so it'll be very interesting, that's for sure. I'm gonna be 100% better than Jordan and Sarah. I got this.
I mean, I used to coach canoeing and kayaking, so I think I'm going to be okay. I mean, although I kind of just like stayed in the motorboat or stayed on the dock, it was more of a telling them what to do rather than telling the kids what to do rather than showing them. I think I'm going to be fine. I think my hair is going to stay dry. And like, without a doubt, I'm going to be better than Jordan and Maria. Like, it's not even a question.
I've done something like, I think even a little bit more difficult, because like, while it's easy to like control like a very small little canoe, it's even more difficult to sit on a large ferry boat. Like, I think like my technical aptitude is really going to be like a skill that I could use. I've also like canoed in one of those big canoes like once or twice, or like 100 times. So like, if I can do that like 14 beers in, like I've got no problem like doing this.
Okay, so we're here with Coach Patrick. All right, so what are the odds of us keeping this boat up?
You're pretty good chance to flip it in the water. This isn't gonna, like.
It's not gonna go over well, but we'll see. Okay, so who's gonna go up first?
Shoddy Dog.
No, I'm not going first.
It's all you.
Hey, it's all you.
I never said I was good. I
thought you. I'm gonna move to the back of the boat.
Oh my god! Why are you pushing me out so much?
Pull up your paddle. Pull up your paddle.
Go up your paddle. No, bring me back.
Turn the.
Oh my god! I'm kind of doing it.
Scoop facing you, Sarah. Paddle forward.
No.
Okay, scoop facing towards you.
Other way.
Hey.
Just start paddling forward.
I was still better than him.
Dude, I was steering and then it just fell apart.
I went to like the bridge and back.
Yeah, okay. All right, so why don't you tell us what's next?
What we have next is our Sprint Canoe C1. Which is a little tippier than the first kayak you tried.
All right, let's give it a shot.
Let's give it a shot. Oh yeah! Woo. I'm frozen, I can't move my body. But that was awesome! Sarah, come at me. So cold in my life. That was the coldest water I think I've ever swam in.
All right, well, we're gonna get Jordan some tea or coffee or something.
Or a blow dryer.
Yeah, something. We're gonna warm up Jordan. Special thanks to the Mississauga Canoe Club for having us. And this has been Give It a Shot at Canoe and Kayak.
Never again.
Mississauga Canoe Club for having us out. It was just a tad cold, eh, guys?
Yeah, nipples definitely poking through the shirt after falling in the
water. 100%. Hashtag wish Jordan fell out of a plane instead.
Yeah.
Don't we all? All right, so make sure if you want more content, exclusive content, as a matter of fact, check out our website, outsidethepressbox.com. Post new stuff every day. After the break, more stuff coming up, including our blooper reel. You don't want to miss it here on OTP.
Thank you.
Do you remember that scene from that movie on Netflix? The team was down, huh? And the coach, he gave that speech. Yeah. You remember that scene?
Yeah.
Remember what he said?
Yeah.
Well, that, gentlemen, is what I am saying.
You gotta get it to get it. Watch movies, TV episodes, and original series instantly on your TV and more.
Tune it up, KD.
That sounds good right there.
Don't mess this up.
Please tell me the camera was on.
Special edition Christmas Day uniforms now available.
Everybody, and welcome back to Outside the Press Box. I mean, you're still hanging around with us. We must be doing something, right? Now it's time for outsider trading. So basically what happens, we're going to cross the boundaries between professional sports and trade players between cities from different sports. So let's get started. All right, so we're going to start off with you, Maria. What is your outsider trade?
All right, so I got two for you. Batista going to the Tampa Bay Rays. He's an expiring contract. The Jays can definitely benefit from that. Valencia and Colabello can share those right fielder responsibilities, and the Jays can get a pitcher for sure.
Okay, so who is this for?
This is for Batista going to the Rays.
And then who is the other player from the other city?
Stamkos is going to the Leafs. Obviously, Ooh. The Leafs could benefit from a new center. And why wouldn't Stamkos go? It's a new team. They're rebuilding. It's a chance for him to get new management and start fresh.
I like it. And also, it could give the Leafs a shot at the playoffs as opposed to
and
the Jays.
And Stamkos can do a stick flip, like a bat flip.
Yeah. There you go.
Basically the same thing.
Yeah.
All right. I like that very much. Stan, what's your outsider trade?
Okay. You said you want to trade players from different sports, from different cities. How about different countries?
Different countries. Mind blown.
Okay. Canada soccer team, currently 102nd in the FIFA rankings. We're right above Benin.
What?
Do you know where Benin is?
I've met a guy named Ben. Does that count?
No. It's right near Togo and Ghana.
Where?
In Africa. Togo and Ghana.
Okay.
Okay, so.
I can't even picture these like, on a map. I would like, where do you see these on a map?
I would like Togo there.
Okay. That's not really the point of this whole thing. So, the fact is, we don't really matter when it comes to men's soccer internationally. Another team doesn't matter internationally. The Argentinian ice hockey team just started in 2012. Currently have a record of 1-6 internationally. Canada once romped them 18-0 in international play. So what I'm thinking, both teams need a little bit of help. And both countries are good at one of those sports. So Canada, we send Sidney Crosby over to Argentina in exchange for Lionel Messi. Both have had some great success on the international stage. Crosby, of course, scoring the golden goal in the Olympics. Messi, he's won an Olympic gold actually in soccer too when they won it in 2008. Both are at 28 years old. Both currently in the prime of their career. Both can help out each other's countries.
That could definitely
work. I like
work.
That. Just having to get like the visas straight would be all you have to do.
The visas would be tough.
Yes. Jordan, it's your turn.
Well, here's the thing, guys. This show is not Inside the Press Box, that poor knockoff of this great show. And this is not insider trading. Ladies and gentlemen, let's get outside the box. This is outsider trading. You guys are looking at people for their athletic abilities, yes?
True.
You want to look at them for their medical disabilities. Let's trade only diabetic players. And I'm thinking about three cities, Chicago, Phoenix, and a little place called Philadelphia, the city of brotherly love. You following where I'm going with this? Leaving the Chicago Bears will be quarterback Jay Cutler. He will join the Arizona Cardinals. Leaving the Arizona Coyotes
now.
Will be Max Domi, the new young forward for them, also diabetic, and he will be off and joining a little team I like to call the Philadelphia Flyers, Sarah.
I think they like to call him that too.
Yes. Do you guys remember XJ, Dustin McGowan? He pricks his fingers for fun. Diabetic. He is going to Chicago to join the Cubs. three diabetics, they're on the move today.
So this is clearly something that's very close to your heart, Jordan.
I don't know. Close to my heart or close to my pancreas. Right?
Oh my
god. Okay there, Wally.
Eva.
Wally.
All right, well, Jordan checks his blood sugar. We're going to head to another commercial break, but don't, like, leave. Come back, because we want you to see our blooper reel right after this.
I could be in a coma.
Well, you only need the light when it's burning low. Only miss the sun when it starts to snow. Only know you love her when you let her go. Only know you've been high when you're feeling low. Only hate the road when you're missing home. Only know you love her when you let her go. And you let her go.
We should outlaw the wave in baseball stadiums. No more of that, or you'll be arrested. Coaches in every single sport should have to wear the uniforms of that sport, not just baseball coaches. That's not fair. T-shirt guns should become burrito guns. When playing basketball, if you take three steps before dribbling, that should be a penalty. We should call that traveling.
Garbage Time with Katie Nolan, starting March 15th on Fox Sports 1.
All right, guys, we are back and we are here with our last segment, and that is my favorite segment. I've said that actually a lot today, but it's the blooper reel where we check out some of the funniest things that have been happening in sports recently. So let's take a look.
Now, are these bloopers of us on the show today?
No. There was a number.
So to start off with some puck, Kings Flyer Simon Gange being honored before the game, his son is left hanging by Dustin Brown. Aww,
that's crazy. There's like the fake little
he's like,
you're here. Right. Let's shake hands.
Now, Flames at Panthers. Victor Trocheck thinks he scored, but the puck never actually.
Trocheck yourself before you tro-wreck yourself, Victor.
That sucks.
Oh, that's really uncomfortable for all of us. So take it to the pitch, Greek soccer. Maria, you're going to like this one. Midfielder Leonardo Cornish is hurt.
There's
now
one.
Watch the top.
What are your two uncles doing, Maria?
What kills me is they can't even pick him up. Like, what are you doing?
And the player's like, what are you doing?
Only Greeks. That's just the funny thing. Only Greeks. And then just drops him like that.
That's a regular Friday night for Jordan Henry.
Just up and down,
some
up and down.
Australian League Baseball now. Houston Astros prospect Mark Wick tries catching the ball, but instead breaks the wall.
Slide into your DMs, like.
Yeah. Ooh.
Hurt. He get himself hurt doing that one, though.
That's using your face.
The Dolphins are not having a good season. This isn't news to anyone, and this is one of the reasons why.
Can you, like, save the Dolphins, man? They really need our help.
Henrik Lundqvist is in the Thanksgiving mood, and these fans are not in the Thanksgiving mood.
You know what's funny?
Fighting
I would be that guy. I would be that guy holding on to that stick. Like, do not, I'm not letting
this thing go. He's a stressed out accountant. Him and Dave Smart, just a couple of stressed out accountants battling for it.
This golfer is worried because of a ball, not just his golf ball, though.
Oh,
for sure.
Yeah. For half a second, there was three there.
Yeah. No, and then after the surgery, it was back to,
back to one.
And now, finally, A-Rod with the throw. Breaks the screen.
If he's clean, that TV's fine.
I mean, let's hope Fox has the money
to fix
that. That
makes sense. He was flying from first to third. So.
I don't think they do. Finally, Roman Pollock learns why he should stay as an at-home defenseman.
But
stick! No. Snapped in half. Just like his confidence now for any time he's going to attempt to ever go up to shoot and score. So if you liked any of those bloopers, I mean, I liked them all personally, make sure you tweet us with the hashtag BlooperReel2OTP. You can follow us on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, all of the social medias. And if you want to follow us on social media, you can check out our website, www.outsidethepressbox.com. I mean, if you want to see Jay Henny Eats, what he has to say, any of that stuff, I mean, follow us. Make sure we always update our blog as well. We have lots of online exclusive content. Emily Savard went out to interview the Toronto Maple Leaf fans and see who they would rather kiss, marry, or kill. That stuff that we have online.
Kiss, marry, kill.
To finish off the show, let's see if Jordan can actually dunk a basketball. Woo! Barely over Stan's head. On behalf of everyone on the OTP team, myself, Maria, Stan, Jordan, everyone behind the scenes, thank you and good night. Well done.